An introduction to light and reflection. In the first part of this presentation, you will learn about the factors that affect the speed of light. You will learn how to use the frequency and wavelength of light to calculate speed. We will use the velocity equation for light to find the relationship that exists between light's frequency and wavelength. In the second part of this presentation, we will learn the rules that govern how light reflects off a surface. The most amazing property of light is its speed in a vacuum. The speed of light in empty space is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. It's the fastest speed in the universe. Because nothing can travel faster than the speed of light in a vacuum, Einstein called this speed the cosmic speed limit. Radio waves, microwaves, X-rays, and all other electromagnetic radiations travel at this speed in vacuum. When light leaves a vacuum and enters a medium like water or diamond, it travels at a slower speed. Light slows down so little when it enters air that for most problems, we could assume the speed of light in air is approximately 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. Light traveling in a vacuum could travel 7.5 times around the world in 1 second. Since light is a wave, we can find its velocity by multiplying frequency times wavelength. In order to relate frequency and wavelength, we need to separate frequency and wavelength in the equation. We do this by solving for frequency. When we do, we find there's an inverse relationship between frequency and wavelength. This means that the greater the frequency, the smaller the wavelength, and the greater the wavelength, the smaller the frequency. This is the shape for the plot of frequency and wavelength. Notice when the wavelength is big, the frequency is small, and when the wavelength is small, the frequency is big. Here is a simple plug-in problem. Since we are looking for the wavelength of light in a vacuum, we use the speed 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. You can get that number from page 1 of your reference table. The speed of light depends upon the medium through which it travels. Light has a maximum speed in a vacuum and is 2.5 times slower when it travels through diamonds. In the next part of this presentation, we are going to look at how light reflects off a surface. The left ray in this animation is called the incoming ray, and the right ray is called the reflected ray. Notice that the angle that the incoming ray makes with the dotted line is equal to the angle that the reflected ray makes with the dotted line. The dotted line is called the normal. The normal is always drawn perpendicular to the reflecting surface. The law of reflection states that the angle of incidence equals the angle of reflection. The incoming and the reflected ray will always form the letter V. The angle that the incoming ray makes with the normal equals the angle that the reflected ray makes with the normal. Given the incoming ray, would you be able to draw the reflected ray? Since the angle of reflection equals the angle of incidence, we would first have to measure the angle of incidence using a protractor. The angle of incidence is measured from the normal line to the incoming ray. Here is what the reflected ray would look like. The incident ray and the reflected ray make the letter V. Which letter correctly shows the reflected ray? The answer is C. Since the angle of incidence is measured from the normal, and the normal is always drawn perpendicular to the reflecting surface, the angle of incidence in this picture is 60 degrees. When using a protractor to measure angles, ignore the angles greater than 90 degrees. Here is how you use your protractor to measure angles of incidence and angle of reflections. Place the zero line of your protractor on the normal and point the curve side of your protractor towards the angle you are measuring. Remember that we only use the angles on the protractor that are less than 90 degrees. In order to draw the reflecting angle, we need to point the curve of the protractor towards the reflected ray while placing the zero line on the normal. Let's look at it a second time. In order to measure the angle of incidence, we put the zero line on the dotted line, the normal, and we put the curve of the protractor pointing towards the ray. To draw the reflected ray, we put the curve of the protractor towards the reflected side. We put the zero line of the protractor on the normal, mark off 60 degrees, and draw the reflected ray. Angle B represents the angle of incidence, the angle that the incident ray makes with the normal, and angle C represents the angle of reflection, the angle that the reflected ray makes with the normal. You are given the angle between the reflected ray and the incident ray and are asked for the angle of incidence and reflection. Since each of these angles are measured with respect to the normal, we find the answer by dividing by 2. The image from a plane mirror is virtual and upright. Virtual means realistic, and upright means straight up and down. The reason why we say the image produced by a plane mirror is virtual and not real can be illustrated by looking in the mirror while wearing a shirt that has words on it. When we do this, we see that the words on our shirt are reversed from left to right. You may have seen that the words on an ambulance are sometimes reversed so that they can be seen correctly in a rear view mirror. The shape on the left represents the image, and the shape on the right represents the reflection. The incident ray, the normal line, and the reflected ray are all on the same plane. The distance an object is in front of a mirror equals the distance the image is behind the mirror. So as you walk backwards in front of a mirror, the image that you see appears further behind the mirror. There are two basic kinds of reflection: regular reflection, which produces an image, and diffuse reflection, which does not. Regular reflection is a reflection of a polished surface. Regular reflection produces an image. When light reflects off a bumpy or irregular surface, you cannot see an image. Think about it. When lake is calm, you can see your face reflected off the surface of the water, but when the lake is turbulent, you no longer see your image. If you look at the astronaut's face shield, you can see the reflection of another astronaut. Since this reflection produces an image, it's an example of regular reflection. This is the end of my presentation on an intro to light and reflection.